School Freeware's Visual Basic Express 2010 Tutorials. Tutorial 27. The Application Wrap-Up for SpeakABcs, Part 11 of 11. Okay, it's about time to wrap things up. There's just a few minor details that I'd like to cover before this project is launched. So let's put in a button. Resize. I'm going to call this button Quit. The text will be quit. And the font will be font size 20. I'll double click on the button. And let's put in close for the code. Go ahead, try that out. And then I'll go ahead and use the control click method to highlight all the buttons. I'll go over to the events and make sure that key press is set to 4 main key press, so that way if any of the buttons has a focus, key press will continue to work. From there, I'll go to properties, fill the buttons actively highlighted, and I'll go to tab stop and put tab stop as false, so that way the tab cannot work with these buttons. Simply because I don't want the young child to accidentally click on tab while they're typing on the keyboard and moving the tab around, pressing space or enter or any other key, causing the buttons to click. So that way only the mouse can click on the buttons, or you can use the keyboard shortcuts to activate the code within the buttons. I'll do the same thing by control clicking on the radio buttons, and I'll set tab stop to false. Next, when I go ahead and run the form, I find that I can type faster than what the letters are being said. So I like to pause the computer to prevent this from happening. So I'll go quit this down. Go into form design. And what I'm going to do is go over and find the system timer. Drop that in. I'll call the timer ABCs. Enable will be true. And it's set to 1/10 of a second intervals. So what I'm going to do is go into the timer. And before I put the code in, what I'll do is I'll just go up here and I'll create a count variable as an integer. Under for main load, I'll initialize count to equal 1. And within then the timer, if count is greater than or equal to 1, and count is less than 6, then count will increase by 1. Else, count is equal to 7. So when count is equal to 7, we can go ahead and tell the computer to accept a key press. So if count equals 7, then go ahead and accept the key press. I'll go end the count statements end if here. And I'll set count back to equal 1. So that way, when count is 1, the timer will increment until count equals 7, and then we could key press again. So go ahead, run.
GTRYUIKL.
Go ahead, quit. I go to build ABCs. And go to the location where the build is. So in this case, it would be my computer, documents, Visual Studio 2010, projects, SpeakABcs, SpeakABcs again, the bin, and release. And if I go ahead and run within the release, let's see what happens if I don't have the WAV folder within the location where the application is. So we get a nasty error message. Quit this down. I'll go back to SpeakABcs, and I think what I'll do is just put in a try. Catch, so I'll try to play the file. I'll catch the error. Say message box. Please reinstall the program. Wave folder not found. From there, end try. Go back to build SpeakABcs. Go back to the release folder. And try the application without the wave folder again. Quit. Make one modification. Make it a little bit easier to read. Everything looks good. I'll go ahead and build SpeakABcs. Go ahead, put the SpeakABcs program on the desktop. I have the WAV folder on the desktop.
GR905.
Everything looks pretty good, and I believe we're done. I'll go ahead and put the SpeakABcs code on the website for you to download and modify if you choose.